I'm going to describe how fugacity changes with temperature for a single component. In order to do that, because we calculate fugacity from the departure function, which is a function of Gibbs free energy, I also will look at how the Gibbs free energy and the departure function for the Gibbs free energy change with temperature. So we're going to use propane. We're keeping the pressure constant. And so for a constant pressure system, the change, differential change in Gibbs free energy, well, let's look at the general form, VdP minus SdT. Constant pressure, then this term is zero. Entropy is positive, so as we raise the temperature, the Gibbs free energy decreases. And indeed, that's what we see when we plot this for propane. And what might not be completely clear, here there's a break in the slope and it becomes steeper. So here's higher temperature vapor, lower temperature liquid. That break in the slope at the saturation temperature, because the entropy of the vapor is greater than entropy of the liquid, then we would expect that steeper slope. Now, if we look at the departure function, so this is the difference between the Gibbs free energy and the Gibbs free energy if the species, in this case propane, were an ideal gas at the same conditions. And so, not surprising, in the liquid phase, we have a pretty large deviation from ideal gas. As we raise the temperature, notice that the difference becomes very small, becomes close to zero, because we're getting closer here to an ideal gas. Higher temperature at the same pressure, molecules are going to be interacting less likely to have attractive forces, for example, that makes the liquid phase. If we now look at fugacity, which is calculated from the departure function, and so the fugacity, let's look at first the behavior, and then we'll discuss how it's calculated. So here is the liquid. So this is the fugacity at saturation conditions for a liquid. Now the saturation pressure goes up exponentially, and the fugacity also goes up exponentially. Phase change here, so vapor phase. Now the fugacity is increasing less, but notice we're again approaching ideal gas, because out here the fugacity should equal the pressure. The pressure is 1 megapascals. We're approaching a fugacity 1 megapascals as we approach an ideal gas at these high temperatures. And the fugacity is calculated from the relation that the Gibbs free energy minus the Gibbs free energy ideal gas at the same conditions over gas constant and temperature is the natural log of the fugacity over the pressure. And remember, at high temperatures, we think of fugacity as like a corrected pressure. It's close to the pressure of the gas. But at low pressures, it's quite far from the gas pressure. So the idea is that over the entire temperature range, we can see fugacity increases as we increase the temperature for a single component.